the surgical treatment of diabetes. Diabetes, the silent killer of mankind. The disease which causes maximum morbidity to mankind. Diabetes. Statistical data generated world over bears testimony to this very fact. Nearly 300 million people are diabetic in this world. And our own country, India, tops the list with more than 50 million diabetics. And above all, the most alarming observation, Kerala has become the diabetes capital of the world with maximum number of diabetics.
Till this time, there are a lot of newer technology to tackle the diabetes mellitus. We know that there are a lot of research is going on to treat these diabetes patients, from the tablets, from the various type of the insulins, from the islet cell pancreatic transplantation, and for the pancreas transplant for the type 1 diabetes mellitus. Overall, in spite of all these newer modalities, if you take the statistics, the mortality because of the diabetes, mortality from the diabetes is very much unacceptable, because if the statistics shows that once the age advances, almost 80% of these diabetes patients are dying prematurely. So this is all the clinical facts.
Developing newer treatment modalities for diabetes has always been a major area of research in the medical field. Such a breakthrough happened recently as a chance discovery, along with the surgical treatment of morbidly obese patients, the bariatric surgery.
The treatment for the obese patient is the bariatric surgery. Once the BMA has come above 35 BMA or 32 BMA with the two comorbidities, the only permanent solution to treat these obese patients are bariatric surgery. In bariatric surgery, we know that we are altering the gastrointestinal tract. So when we do the altering the gastrointestinal tract, we found that when we treat these obese patients, almost 35 to 40% of these obese patients are diabetes patients. And these obese patients, after the bariatric surgery, these patients' diabetes is getting cured.
This very interesting observation that diabetes gets cured after a bariatric surgery prompted researchers to explore further.
From 1967 onwards, these researchers, we found that there are almost 100 hormones produced from our gastrointestinal tract, and 30 hormones are named ones. So if you tell, this is the largest endocrine organ of our body, if you ask, I would say it is the gastrointestinal tract, because there are almost 100 hormones secreted from the gastrointestinal tract. So in that, the bariatric surgery, what we are, one of the operations is the gastric bypass. Gastric bypass means we are diverting the food nutrients from the duodenum and the jejunum, and it is directly going into the ileum. So this is to reduce the absorption of the food for the bariatric we are doing. But that has got a very good advantage for these diabetes patients. So there is some hormones which is secreted from the duodenum and the jejunum, which reduce the secretion of the insulin from the pancreas, or it has got the increase the insulin resistance, or it decreases the sensitivity of the insulin in the peripheral tissue.
To simplify, there are certain hormones secreted from the duodenum and jejunum which worsen diabetes, and certain other hormones from ileum which improves diabetes. So bypassing the duodenum and jejunum leads to the cure of diabetes. The pioneers in this field of diabetes research are Dr. Francisco Rubino and Dr. Orio Di Polo, and they have put forth the foregut-hindgut theories.
The foregut theory means if we are not stimulating the foregut, there is a decrease of the gut hormones, which is bad for the glucose homeostasis. That hormones, they grouped as anti-incretins. And when the food is reaching the ileum, it will stimulate the secretion of something which is good for the glucose homeostasis. So those hormones, they named it as incretins. So ultimately we need a alteration of the gastrointestinal tract which will increase the incretins. Again, good for the glucose homeostasis, it will reduce the blood glucose level. Similarly, if we the Fogart theory, if we divert the duodenum and the jejunum, that will reduce the anti-incretins level. So again, get a better glucose homeostasis.